Vážené dámy a pánové, přeji pěkné odpoledne a je mi velkou
čest. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to wish you a very good afternoon. And I just wish to say how happy I am I can present our involvement in addressing societal aspects and healthcare solutions of pandemic or COVID-19 pandemic. I'll talk about the matching or rather combination of fundamental research and its translation into practice, that is applied research. I also wish to stress the importance of all national assistance and the already highlighted volunteering. Now let's talk about the mix of basic or fundamental and applied research. We have talked a lot about all kinds of structures at our university. We have got a broad spectrum of portfolio of infrastructures, both from ESRI and national research infrastructures. And it has also been said that universities with their infrastructures do represent a strategic infrastructure of the state. I was happy to hear that both these infrastructures and scientists in both fundamental and applied research immediately at the beginning of the crisis offered their assistance. They sent emails, they were ready to go and help in hospitals or hospital labs, and also subsequently to actually introduce diagnostics and associated activities at the university. Let me talk about the infrastructures involved at our university, whether by testing our National Center of Medical Genomics and others. Many have offered their assistance, free of charge assistance to scientists or researchers who actually develop the new methods for testing. I'll start about testing. I'll start talking about testing at the beginning already. It was covered or presented by Mr. Konvalinka, Mr. Hajduch, namely the following. At SATEC MU, we enjoyed a certain advantage. When it was already built, medical exploitation was simply planned. So we have always had accredited facility, diagnostic laboratory in line with 1589 normal standard. And as of the beginning, we plan to be able to use all the devices, very costly devices, and their use in medical diagnostics prior to coronavirus for diagnosing oncological patients or other patients. That was therefore simple to simply ask these staff who had this previous experience already, plus we had top quality virologists who with my BSL-3 laboratory available. Therefore, that's biosafety level 3. So within a short period of time, we could easily use it for the diagnostics for coronavirus 9 by means of PCR. Now, apart from helping the teaching hospital and other hospitals, we also helped other welfare organizations, a municipality of the city of Bern, and other diseases, charity, testing homeless people, and so on and so forth. Now, even though we were ready full embedding, we had to elaborate or develop a brand new system for testing material. The best option was to set up four teams, one for triage, that means receiving of samples and record keeping, since, as has been said, oftentimes we got it in a bucket with labels or request forms on it. Then BSL3 lab, that was another team where the experts for diagnostics fully protected, opened the or unwrapped the samples and did the isolation or extraction of viral RNA. And the most then qPCR, and the most time consuming in terms of administrative activities was then the registration of results, export to ISIN, etc. I wish to thank Marianne Heiduch, Marianne Heiduch and his team. We also wish to thank many of you from a number of institutions for the Corona Test Hackathon, where we could share information, share experience, exchange experience on the Slack platform throughout the country. We involved the genomics core facility, in particular, in the testing activities, and all we had due to the initial lack of material, we developed in-house isolations or extraction method on the locally produced components. Thanks to that, we got involved in the extraction of RNA development by means of magnetic beads, and we also work on other methods. Now, this method that we worked with Charles University, Olomouc University, and subsequently the result was our own technical method, which can be used not only on tapped for coronavirus, but for other viruses as well. Now, this now we work on LAMP, RT-LAMP method, that is loop-mediated isothermal amplification. And since we heard a lot in the morning about PCR method, I'm not going to go into any further detail, but it also works with sub. It's based on the chain reaction, polymerase chain reaction, and we believe that it's going to be a method easy to evaluate, usable in field, etc. So these activities too took place thanks or take place thanks to all kinds of research infrastructures, MCLG, ARTRIS, and we guess that this new kit will have certified, that means the kit for point of care testing, POCT, available with IVD certification. Now, many offered access to laboratories for free, like infrastructure for structural biology, and this resulted in first publications or preprints and also further research of the virus is underway. So I appreciate this activity very much, just like activities with other research facilities. Now, we had a model of epidemiological testing of population, or a pilot project that monitors natural cause of the infection or disease. The first one, in the first, that is model of epidemiological testing of population, was done by, or also by Pavel Plevka, who is an investigator of ERC, MBO, etc. And he does the testing, they do the testing of representative more sample of population for SARS-CoV-2 infection, and also they are now working on the identification of that part of population that is natural resistant to COVID-19. Now, coordinate the second example. That is an activity or project coordinated by the pilot project monitoring the natural course of COVID-19 disease or infection. So the main or primary objective is regular or remote monitoring of health status of COVID-19 positive persons, focus on their respiratory signs, then to follow morbidity, mortality, and consequences of the infection. Questions are asked concerning physical aspects and then societal or social impacts, and we shall also have them tested for immune response or genetic information. This is a project underway now, and I believe that it is very promising. It will help us collect valuable information. Information is handed over to the Institute of Medical Information Statistics. Then I also talked about the Institute of Biostatistics and Analysis of Medical Faculty of Masaryk University and their assistance with IMIS, who process the information on the state of play or actual situation or health status and potential development of COVID-19, and all that under the coordination and leadership of Professor Dušek. Now, projects that in-house we announced, called for, thanks to the internal in-house call by technical center of CT through Simplen. These are internal calls for proof of concept projects, namely rapid response by technology transfer office, a project concerning rapid diagnostics by LAMP lamp method, then development of online platform for monitoring, analysis and management of epidemiological situations in real time, which is now underway. Yet another significant project is done by the Faculty of Science, physicists who develop special nanofibers into the filters for filtration purposes, or to be used simply in filters. And we have anthropologists from our university who optimize the dimensions of respirators for children and adolescents in order for the respirators to fit. Now, apart from these rather science-oriented projects, there are many economic or social science-related projects, like those focused on the role of the religious systems and in the solution of collective threats associated with the pandemic, then social workers related things, then a survey on education of children at home, from home, physical activity in the period of pandemics, etc. All national assistance during the period of COVID-19 pandemic. We had been very active. There was a center, volunteering center, or center of volunteers immediately, almost immediately set up, which does play the social and societal role. It was set up on the 13th of March, and it is still active, up and running. Upon the appeal of Martin Barash, the rector, huge number of persons interested from among the students, academia, general public, altogether 4,500 people worked as volunteers. They offered help to institutions as well as to individuals. They have processed or acted upon more than 2,500 applications or requests for assistance in Brno and other regions, and there was a collection organized. Altogether, 2,400,000 crowns were collected, and then activities. So it was used as a support for homeless people and other vulnerable groups. Now these are the collection tents, as you can see, without the assistance of students or medical faculties, we could have hardly done all the sample collections. And they also helped during the epidemiological study. Now, these spots show the places where the volunteers came from all over the country. And that is something we very much appreciate. I'd like to express most cordial thanks to them. Now, they have, as I've said, acted upon 2,500 requests for assistance, seniors, children's home, hospitals, elderly care facilities, hotlines, simply, and also individual persons like elderly people in particular. Ask for, I don't know, shopping, for, you know, arrangement or face masks delivery, and picking up drugs for pharmacies, pets walking, take babysitting, and so on and so forth. Now, assistance was requested especially in the Moravian region, but it was also rendered everywhere else, including Prague. Now, what now all different faculties. Faculty of Medicine is obvious. That means with respect to testing tents and work at the region public health authority in regional or other hospitals. But also the Faculty of Social Studies, people helped a lot. They worked in the centers for homeless. Then very efficient and effective help was babysitting or taking care of children of hospital staff. And that was predominantly done by the undergraduates of Faculty of Pedagogy, then Arts, and also of Sciences, Faculty of Science. Sports faculty or sports science faculty organized exercises or all kinds of activities for seniors and general public. The teaching hospital in Brno on the 13th of March was actually exposed to or was hit by cyber attacks. So no IT systems actually were up and running, and that was a challenge at the time of first patients coming in who were taken down by COVID. So as concerns media coverage, Well, generally speaking, it's very desirable to have all these activities widely covered by media. Statistical returns here, I mean different faculties and the number of the contributions or posts, etc. in media simply. People become more aware of the importance of such workplaces then, especially at the time of crisis. By way of conclusion, I would like to stress three aspects. Obvious became the irreplaceable role of the combination of fundamental and applied research in solving, or rather trying to meet the needs of society. Now they started to work together, which was a source of enrichment for the researchers or scientists, and it also helped tackle or solve the crisis and reflect the needs of the society. And the universities, as well as other academia, helped a lot with down-to-earth or practical things. They acted also as advisory teams or groups, and thanks to that, I believe we are ready for all kinds of crises, be it floods, drought, or whatever. Now all the organizations and institutions will be ready and prepared to respond. And the all national need or benefit of research infrastructure has become clearly visible, especially when it came to the role in solving acute medical and social problems. And the third role of university, that means volunteering by students, undergraduates and scientists, has been highlighted. I guess we, to a degree, enjoyed it, and such a good mood and sense of cooperation should prevail. Thank you. Thank you for attention, and I thank everyone whom we had the pleasure of working with to in helping tackle this crisis.